It's the International Soccer Preview, and we are Soccer Files Canada. Welcome to Series 28, looking at the groups and teams of the 2024 Copa America. This episode is looking at the players of Chile. Here we go! Hello, welcome again to the International Soccer Preview by Soccer Files Canada. I'm Kevin, and we continue Series 28 on the groups and players of the 2024 Copa America. This episode covers Chile's players, and it's actually part two of the players media cast. Here we look at the selections. In part one, we made a list of the candidates and introduced them and their likelihood of making the squad. And there is a link to that, part one, in the show notes. This episode, part two, will be divided into three sections. In section one, we'll take a quick look at their preliminary squad and their warm-up games. In section two, the main part of the media cast here, we overlook the list that we compiled in part one to see who made it and who didn't. And then in section three, we summarize the surprises in the selections and review injuries. Let's begin then. Just some preliminary information on the preliminary roster. So for Chile, it was a 55-man preliminary roster published very early on May 17th, more than a month before the tournament there. And then almost a month later, on June 13th, they reduced that to 26 men. So 29 players cut there. And there we have it. I forgot to move the graphic onto the section that we're doing. So here we go, YouTube watchers. So it's 55 players, 29 of them to be cut as we go through our list. And let's talk a little bit about the warm-up game. A little different than most teams. First of all, Chile had just one warm-up game. And second of all, it was in Chile, whereas most teams are playing in the USA their warm-up games. We can't say for sure whether it's the starting lineup. It kind of looks close to it, but we do think there are a couple of kind of experimental or, you know, substitute slash bench players coming on because they're not the starters we thought they were going to be. That could mean, on the other hand, that we were wrong and that these players are being considered as starters, even though they didn't necessarily look that way from their participation since the beginning of 2023. Nevertheless, we'll point out who played in that warm-up game. And we move on to part two, or section two, the candidates. So we begin with the manager. And Ricardo Gorica, we'll call him selected because he was not dismissed or anything before the tournament began. And we're going to have some new candidates, of course, with that huge 55-man preliminary roster. And we begin by adding a couple of names to the goalkeeper list. We'll put them at the end here in the new section and then come back and talk about them a little bit. So the first one is English-born Lawrence Vigourou. And the second one, USA-born Vicente Reyes. So we'll come back to those players, but first of all, look at the candidates that we had. And we begin with the definite candidate in Brian Cortez. Two likely candidates. Claudio Bravo, captain of the team, so probably more than likely. But based on recent participation, we said likely. And the other one was also at the likely level, Gabriel Arias. So all three of those selected. Not our possible candidate, Fernando De Paul. He didn't even make the big preliminary squad. Neither of our new candidates, Lawrence Vigourou or Vicente Reyes. Oh, suddenly lost my voice there. Okay, so it is Cortez, Claudio Bravo, and Gabriel Arias. In the warm-up game, Claudio Bravo started, and now that he is back, Starting with the team, I think he'll probably be the starter here. Our definite candidate didn't get any time. Actually, Gabriel Arias subbed in for Bravo in at halftime of that game. So Brian Cortes, despite being the only definite candidate, looks like he might be the third string keeper here. Anyway, those decisions, definite and likely, were based on participation, and we kind of explained in part one of this podcast our reasoning behind those decisions. Let's move on to central midfield. What am I talking about? Let's move on to central defenders. And here we don't have any definite candidates. So we begin with likely candidates, and there are four of them. The first one is Paulo Diaz, who was selected for the squad. Secondly, Guillermo Maripan. He does have an injury tag on him, which we'll talk about later, but overcame it enough at least to be able to be named to the preliminary squad. Third one, a bit of a surprise, veteran Gary Medel. Not selected for the preliminary, selected for the preliminary squad, not selected for the final squad. There. And the fourth likely candidate was Matthias Catalan, and he was selected for the final squad. We had two possible candidates, the first of which, Igor Lichnovsky was selected for the squad, but the other possible candidate, Francisco Sierralta, only named to the preliminary squad, but didn't make the final cut. And then we had two possible but unlikely candidates in Jonathan Villagra and Matthias Zaldivia, and neither of those named even to the preliminary squad. However, we had a couple of candidates who seemed to be off the squad, the first of which, Benjamin Kusevich, was named to the final squad. So he had not started the last six matches, so he seemed to be off the squad for us, but he does have seven caps for the national team since 2018 and is 28 years old. So Benjamin Kusevich, we might be seeing him in the tournament. The other two seemingly off the squad players were named for the preliminary squad, Enzo Rocco. He has an injury tag on him, and that might have been part of the decision, given that he was selected for the preliminary squad. Might have been part of the decision not to select him in the end. We don't know. The other one, seemingly off the squad, Sebastian Vegas, also named to the preliminary squad, but not making the final cut. Let's look and see what we saw in the warm-up game. We expected that Paulo Diaz would be one of the central defenders. At the end of part one, we went through and nominated players who we were confident were going to be starters. However, Paulo Diaz did not start. Instead, it was one of our possible candidates, Igor Lichnovsky, and the fourth of our likely candidates, Matthias Catalan, both started in that 4-2-3-1 formation, so two central defenders. So in that case, I mean, it may be that one of those is being considered as a starter, but we consider it kind of a B-team selection there, maybe just giving them some field time. But who knows, we'll have to see in the cup if I'm right in that. All right, that was a lot of players, but it was for two positions. And we'll move on to the left back, which is just one position. But we have two new candidates here too, Eric Weinberg and Nicolas Diaz. We'll come back to them at the end of the section. Let's look at the candidates we had from part one. And the first one was a definite candidate in Gabriel Suazo. And we had a likely candidate in Thomas Galdames. Both of those were selected, Suazo and Galdames. We had a possible but unlikely candidate in veteran Eugenio Mena. And he was selected for the preliminary squad, but didn't make the final cut. And then also the two new candidates, Eric Weinberg and Nicolas Diaz, neither of those making the final cut either. Looking at the warm-up game, or actually at our starter list, we had nominated Gabriel Suazo as a starter, and he did start in the warm-up game. So we think he's going to be starting in the final, in the cup as well. Over to the right backs, and here we had no definite or likely candidates. So that indicates that it's pretty unstable situation with several candidates being used there, and there are four possible candidates. The first one, Mauricio Isla, the veteran there, 35 years old, and selected for the final squad. The second one, Juan Delgado, was not selected even for the preliminary squad. He had a tag on him for injury, and it seems like injury kept him out there. Or, you know, we're presuming that injury played a role in his non-selection because he wasn't named for the preliminary squad. The third candidate, Nicolas Fernandez, was selected for the final squad. And the fourth one, Philippe Loyola, made the preliminary squad but not the final cut, but we think that's due to an injury. We're not sure, he was only a possible candidate, but he did pick up an injury in the warm-up game. We'll talk about that in section three. We had one possible but unlikely candidate in Nael Misatu, and he was not selected for the even the preliminary squad. Okay, let's look at who started as the right back in the warm-up game, and it was Mauricio Isla. So it looks like he is going to be the one. Okay, yeah, he had come back after an absence to play in their March games, so stepping back into his old role there. Onto the midfield, and we look at defensive midfielders. We had a definite candidate. No, I'll just mention a new candidate first. That's Ulises Ortigoza. We'll put him on the list under new and talk about him at the end. Our definite candidate was Rodrigo Echeverria, and he was selected. And we had a likely candidate in I think I put him in the wrong spot in part one. He's on the likely list, but in my notes, he's a possible candidate. And it turns out that's more close to the truth, because he was selected, Williams Alarcon, to the preliminary squad, but didn't make the final cut. The same is true of our first possible but unlikely candidate, Vicente Pizarro, on the preliminary squad, but not making it in the end. And Alfred Canales, the other possible but unlikely candidate, not even named to the preliminary squad. We had a couple of players who seemed to be off the squad. One of them was Claudio Baeza. He hadn't appeared since he was on the bench in March of 2022. But coming back to the team after 2 years, or named to the preliminary squad after that two-year absence. However, he was not selected for the final squad. And then our new candidate, Ulises Ortigoza, on the preliminary squad, but not making the cut either. Before we look at the warm-up game, we'll look at the central midfielders as well. And here we have a new candidate. It's the return of veteran Marcelo Diaz coming back. He hadn't appeared for the national team since, get this, 2017. He was on their Confederations Cup squad and for several tournaments before that, including the 2014 World Cup, but had been off the team. But lo and behold, he comes back after a seven-year absence to the squad. And we'll put him at the bottom of the list under the new category. New because we hadn't brought him up in part one. And look at the candidates that we had brought up in part one. So we have a definite candidate, Marcelino Nunez, and he was selected for the squad. And then no likely or no candidates in the likely section, but five in the possible section. The first, Eric Pulgar, was selected. The second, Victor Mendes or Philippe Mendes, selected for the preliminary squad but didn't make the final cut. The third was veteran Charles Aranguiz, and he was not selected even for the preliminary squad. Fourthly, Esteban Pavez did make the final cut and is on the squad. And Cesar Perez, the fifth candidate, also selected for the preliminary squad. We also had one player seemingly off the squad. That was Pablo Galdamez. And he was selected for the preliminary squad, but didn't make the final cut. He had last appeared in June 2022. All right, that is the... No, we're going to add the left and right midfielders before we look at the position, because, well, I'll just do it. I won't explain why I'm doing it. We had a player seemingly off the squad for left midfielder, coded as a left midfielder. It was Oscar Opazo, and he did make the preliminary squad there, but not the final cut. On the right midfielder, we also had only one candidate, Matias Fernandez, and he did not make even the preliminary squad. He was at the possible but unlikely level there. Okay, and let's look at the warm-up game. So we had thought the starting pair would be Rodrigo Echeverria and Marcelino Nunes. That's what we who we nominated when we race through the starters at the end of part one. It turns out that Rodrigo Echeverria was not a starter, but Marcelino Nunes was. I'm really making a long story out of this. Pulgar was the starter. And actually, I do see that as a possibility, Pulgar starting there, and Echeverria left in kind of limbo as far as that goes. But again, we do see a few kind of B-team players or bench players here. So it could be that Echeverria comes back. Okay, let's move on upfield to the left attacker position. And we begin with Ben Brereton, or Ben Brereton Diaz. He'll probably be called Diaz here in this in his South American form. And he was a definite candidate, actually coded as a forward. We moved him over to here, and we explained why in part one, so I won't mention that every time. I'll mention it, though, for Victor Davila, because he's the same. He's our first likely candidate, and Davila was selected for the squad, just like Brereton, or just like Brereton Diaz. However, our other likely candidate, Alexander Aravena, not making it past the preliminary squad. He was named to the preliminary squad, but not selected. On the teams to be off the squad list, we had Gene Meneses, and he was selected for the preliminary squad, but didn't make the final cut there. So that is left attackers. Let's see who made it for the warm-up game. And it, in fact, was the right attacker, who we're going to meet soon, Diego Valdez, switching sides and starting on the left, switching sides with Davila, the second of our... our likely candidate, Davila, getting two goals in the game, as a matter of fact, and starting on the right. So it looks like just a simple switch of sides between Valdez and Davila. However, we still see Brereton Diaz. No, actually, in part one, we saw it as a toss-up between Brereton Diaz and Davila as to who would actually start. So that may indicate what is going to happen in the cup, but we do expect to see Brereton Diaz on the field and possibly starting some of the games. Okay, for the right attack, we have a couple of new candidates, Carlos Palacios and Gonzalo Tapia. We'll come to those at the end, but let's look at our main candidates first. We had the likely Dario Osorio, and he was selected for the squad, for the final squad, overcoming an injury, which we'll talk about in the next section. And here we have Diego Valdez, who we saw starting on the right. He's the first of our possible candidates here for right attacker. And actually, all three of our possible candidates made it. The second was Marcos Bolados, and the third was Christian Zavala. Not only that, but our possible but unlikely candidate also made it, Maximiliano Guerrero. So, wow, five players there in the right attacking part of the field. And only Diego Valdez started in the warm-up game, and he on the left side. So, not sure we're going to see all of those players. But they do have a central attacking position, which these players could move into. The two new candidates, Carlos Palacios and Gonzalo Tapia, only made it to the preliminary squad and were not selected for the final squad. On we go to central attackers, and we have a new candidate in Luciano Cabral. We'll talk about him at the end. We had no definite or likely candidates here, which is why we might see one of the right attackers moving into the center. We had a possible candidate in Arturo Vidal, the veteran, with 142 caps for Chile, but not selected for this tournament, just on the preliminary squad there, Arturo Vidal. The other possible candidate, Lucas Asadi, also just named to the preliminary squad, but not making the final cut. And yes, we had the sad story of Javier Altamirano, who suffered an epileptic seizure on the field. I think it was on the field in March 2024. It was not for Chile, but for his club, and has not overcome that. So not named to the preliminary squad even. I hope he gets better and we see him in the future. The new candidate, Luciano Cabral, only made it to the preliminary squad, but not the final cut. So we have no candidates for central attacking midfield. In the warm-up game, it was forward Alexis Sanchez who played in the role. I don't remember seeing that before. Oh, yes. Actually, he did it in three of the last four games, so I couldn't have been more wrong. So Alexis Sanchez, looking like the starting central attacking player if they use that position. But as I said, bringing five attacking right attacking players suggests that they have more than just one position available in mind for them. Okay, let's go on to the forwards. We've just met Alexis Sanchez, but actually I'm going to add a new candidate before we continue. So Stefan Quino added to the squad, and we'll mention him at the end. Alexis Sanchez, our definite forward, was selected. And so was our likely, sorry, not likely, just possible, Eduardo Vargas, but he was selected. We had one possible but unlikely candidate in Diego Rubio. He made the preliminary squad, but not the final cut. And then we had a raft of players who seemed to be off the squad, six of them. I won't go through them. I'll just mention that two of them were selected. The first one, Philippe Mora, and the second one, Diego Valencia, both of those selected for the preliminary squad, but not making the final cut. And then our new candidate, Stefan Pino, like all of the new candidates I think we've seen, just making the preliminary squad there. Okay, well, that brings us to the end. That was pretty busy with the 55-man preliminary squad. And oh no, I didn't mention the warm-up game. So Eduardo Vargas started as the lone centre forward there because Sanchez was playing as an attacking midfielder behind him. Okay, now we are ready to move on to the surprises. So, first of all, notable non-selections. We have Gary Medel. He was captain of Chile and was a likely candidate in part one, but one of the veterans who didn't make it. We see they are kind of falling off the team here. We'll see a couple of them or several of them here. Anyway, Gary Medel, our first notable non-selection. Next, we have Alexander Aravena. He was a left winger who we had considered a likely candidate, but not selected just for the preliminary squad, just like Gary Medel, not making the final cut. We had Eugenio Mena. He was actually a possible but unlikely candidate. I just mentioned him because he's one of the veterans falling off the squad there. He was named to the preliminary squad but didn't make the final cut. And another veteran, Charles Aránguiz, not even making the preliminary squad. And perhaps saddest of all for me, Arturo Vidal not making the final cut there. He made the preliminary squad. So that's an awful lot of veterans. I even have one more here, and that's Marcelo Diaz, who was named to the preliminary squad. Also coming out of the, or no, we talked about him coming back from his last appearance in September 2017. So he had been off the squad for the last few tournaments. So yes, the passing of a generation right there. Surprise inclusions, we only have two. The first is Benjamin Kusevich, and he is a central defender. He hadn't started none of their games since the start of 2023. He'd been on the bench for three and then not selected for nine others, including the last six matches. So it suddenly hits me with a shock that I introduced him already. So I'll move on to the other surprise selection. That's Maximilian Guerrero. And he was also selected. I didn't introduce him. He's a right winger and got his first cap in November 2023 and started none of their four remaining games, but he was subbed in for one and on the bench for one. And then he wasn't selected for the last two matches. So we weren't surprised he was named to the preliminary squad, but we were surprised that he was named to the final squad, given that limited participation. He plays for Universidad de Chile, actually his second stint with them since 2024, having moved from Deportes de La Serena in Deportes La Serena in Chile. So just one cap for Chile for the 24-year-old, but he might get his second here. Okay, new players. Well, we won't go through all of them, but we'll just list the significant ones. So these are, as I said, new just in terms of they didn't appear on our list. They weren't on our radar for part one. So a lot of these, or some of them, are coming back from an absence, but we won't go into too much detail. We mentioned Marcelo Diaz, the shocking return after a seven-year absence. Carlos Palacios is a right winger. He also made a comeback having last appeared in October 2021, at least to be named to the preliminary squad. And yeah, we introduced the others as we went through, so I think I'll just skip naming them. There are 8 more after this, so there's 10 players in all who were new to the squad. Some of them young players that we might see in the future. Let's go on to the injury section and look at players. So Guillermo Maripan is the first player in our category of those who have recovered from injuries. He was out with a hamstring injury since mid-May. He had been expected to return on May 31st, so he did return and was named to the starting squad there. So he overcame that injury. We didn't see him starting in the warm-up game, but the central defender is selected for the final squad. Same is true with Dario Osorio. He was out with a lower leg fracture since late May. Holy cow, he's back. He missed only the last game of the season and was expected back on June 7th. So as bad as it sounds, a lower leg fracture, it seems like it was a fairly short-term injury. And he was fit enough to be selected for the squad. Also didn't appear in the or didn't start in the warm-up game there. So yeah, maybe I should put those players as injury doubts. Maybe they're still recovering from the injury. We're not sure. That's what doubt means, I suppose. We don't have any players dropped specifically due to injury that we know, but we do have some players who were not strong candidates to begin with. So the injury might have been part of the decision not to, to select them, or they may have simply been not selected. So we had Enzo Rocco. He had an unknown injury that he picked up in mid-May and an unknown return date. He was named to the preliminary squad, but not selected for the final squad there. Enzo Rocco, the central defender, we had as seemingly off the squad. Anyway, he last appeared on the bench in March 2022. Philippe Loyola, though, does seem to be a case of being dropped due to injury. He was a possible candidate for us, the right back, but he picked up an ankle sprain in the warm-up game. And that game was actually 3 days before the final selection. So it may be because of that ankle injury that he wasn't selected. But we're not sure because he was just a possible candidate. Next is right back Juan Delgado, so another right back. He was out with a hip injury since October 2023 and an unknown return date. And was not even named to the preliminary squad. We mentioned Javier Altamirano, so he had an epileptic seizure during a game, a club match in March, and doesn't seem to have recovered from that. We sure hope we see the 20-year-old in the future. And finally, Cesar Fuentes, the defensive midfielder. He was also someone who was seemingly off the squad for us, out with a cruciate ligament tear, and I see he already is not expected to return to soccer until October. So Cesar Fuentes is known to not be a candidate for this one. He beats Marcelo Diaz in having returned to the team in 2023 after an almost 10-year absence, Cesar Fuentes, but he did appear in 2023. All right, that brings us to the end of a long part two, but we hope we have made the tournament more enjoyable for you by knowing who the players are. We would like to thank Paul Udin and Pixabay for the wonderful background music accompanying this media cast. The piece is called Victory Epic Music.